Well, good morning and welcome to Southborough Lane Baptist Church and this, our online service for this week. I am so pleased you've taken the time to be with us, to join us, and I hope that you'll enjoy everything that we have in store, because of course we're still in the season of Lent, making our way towards Easter, Good Friday and the glory of Easter Sunday. But today is also a special day because it is Mother's Day, a day when we honour mothers and mother figures and spiritual mothers. And we're going to be making that very much a theme of all that we're going to be sharing in today. So I'm glad you're here. But let's praise God, the one who ultimately needs our praise because he created mothers. He created all of us and he loves us. So let's participate in, reflect upon, or sing along to How Great Is Our God.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide. It trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? In his hands, the
I'm sure you remember that one of the things that we always love doing on Mother's Day when we're meeting together for live services is for the children to come back into the church at the end of the service and distribute to all the ladies present some daffodils for them to take away, just as a mark of us desiring to honour all the ladies there on that day. Well, of course, we're not meeting together and we can't do that. So I thought it would still be nice to symbolise that. So we have had a draw. And we have drawn one lady from the church family out of the hat who has been chosen to symbolise all the ladies receiving flowers on Mother's Day. Have a look at this. And so here we are with Sandra, a wonderful mum and grandmum from the church. And we want to symbolically use you, Sandra, do something with you that we would normally do for all the ladies at church on Sunday. So on Mother's Day, we want to say to you, Happy Mother's Day!
Oh, Ben, thank you so,
so
much.
There you are. You
oh, they're
are
lovely.
Symbolic recipient of the daffodils.
Thank you.
So, Sandra, Mother's Day, can I ask you, what is the best thing about being a mum?
The best thing about being a mum? Well, where do I start? From the moment you bring home your first baby, you are overwhelmed that this precious gift from God has been given to you. A mum with no training or previous experience, and you are responsible for their development. They are totally dependent on you. Help, you say. You soon find you're being called to be a teacher, a carer, a nutritionist, a spiritual guide, and many, many more things. Despite all your shortcomings, this little baby survives and begins to grow because the one thing you can give is love. And what do you get back in return? Loads of love, lots of laughs, and wonderful experiences, especially being able to witness all the firsts, like the first smile, first steps, first words, first day at school. Your family expands as new brothers and sisters arrive, bringing their own unique personalities to the family. You feel more confident now, but of course there are times of worry and sadness, especially when they are ill or struggling with life. But to see them grow and develop into their own people with their own views, often different from yours, is very satisfying. And when they are independent, they move on. Your job is done. Or is it? Your family grows as they find partners, and soon the grandchildren arrive, and suddenly you're useful again. Grandchildren are so precious and special, and you can have all the enjoyment without all the hard work, and you can give them back at the end of the day. It's great to see your children making the same mistakes with their children as you did with yours. You look on and marvel at new ideas and methods of raising children, often with much amusement. As the grandchildren grow, you realise you're developing a very special bond and relationship with them, which is so rewarding. God is good, and I've been blessed with 4 children and 8 grandchildren, and I pray and thank God for them all every day, as I'm sure you do with yours too.
Sandra, that was brilliant. Thank you so much. Well, we've heard from a mum today. Thank you so much for that. But we also want to hear from a child today. And to help us to do that in a really beautiful way, I'm indebted to Sarah May. Thank you so much, Sarah.
Mother's Day poem. Thank you for standing by me through thick and thin, for not giving up on me when I didn't win, for your patience when I kept pushing you away, for caring when I said I didn't need you anyway. I am grateful knowing I can count on your strength. Ask for support and I know you'll go to any length. When I lose my way, you help me get back on track. When I'm in pain, you comfort, soothes and brings me back. I am blessed because when I'm sad, you gave me faith and hope. When I was confused, you taught me how to cope. When I felt I couldn't go on, you carried me long miles. When I didn't believe, you assorted my smiles. Mum, thank you for your guidance and the faith you've shown, for giving me a safe place when I have grown, for showing me how to strive because of your love. I will survive.
Thank you so much, Sarah. That was beautifully read and a lovely tribute to mums. I'm sure you represent so many of our children who want to say thank you to their mums and their spiritual mums and their mother figures today. Keith and Christine Getty have written a wonderful song entitled A Mother's Prayer.
To sleep, I have a promise still to keep as I hold you in my arms. I pray your little frame grows strong and that faith takes hold while you trust him till the end. May you trust him in the end. This world is not as it should be, but the Savior opens eyes to see all that's beautiful and true. Oh, may his light fill all you are, and the jewel of wisdom crown your heart. This is my prayer for you. Oh, hold my hand, I'll teach you the way to go, through the joys, through the tears, the journey of these years, he is with us till the end. Is faithful till the end. travel where my arms won't reach, as the road will rise to lead your feet on a journey of your own. May my mistakes not hinder you, but His grace remain and guide you through. This is my prayer for you. This will be my prayer for you. Father, hear my ceaseless prayer. Oh, keep her in your care.
The reading this morning is taken from the Gospel according to John, starting at chapter 19, verse 23 to 27. When the soldiers crucified Jesus, they took his clothes, dividing them into four shares, one for each of them, with the undergarment remaining. This garment was seamless, woven in one piece, from top to bottom. "Let's not tear it," they said. "Let's decide by lot who will get it." This happened that the scripture be fulfilled, that said, "They divided my clothes among them and cast lots for my garment." So this is what the soldiers did. Near the cross stood his mother's sister Mary, wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby. He said to her, "Woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, the disciple took her into his home. May the Lord add a blessing to that reading.
Well, as I said earlier, we're still in the season of Lent, moving towards Easter. But of course, today is also Mother's Day. And so I would like us to kind of cover both aspects. I would like us to look at one of the sayings of Jesus from the cross. There were seven, as recorded in the Gospels. The first was Jesus praying to his Father, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." The second was when he turned to one of the thieves being crucified with him and said, "Truly, I tell you, tonight you will be with me in paradise." But it's the third saying of Jesus from the cross that I want us to look at this morning. When Jesus saw his mother there and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to her, "Woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." Well, the first point is this: why we value mothers. And to help us, let's think about Mary for a moment and try to put ourselves in her shoes. Mary would, of course, now, by the time of Jesus's crucifixion, have been much older. And I'm sure the way she was physically would have shown that. She'd raised a house full of children. And now she is watching her firstborn being crucified. She must have felt uneasy that day because she and a few friends, there were five of them in all, were very much in the minority. They were part of a big crowd that was really anti-Jesus. And there were the soldiers and the Jewish religious leaders. There was the angry mob, and they were all heaping insults on Jesus. As the commentator Herschel Hobbes writes, "In this vast ocean of hate, there was a tiny island of love and understanding. That's Mary, Jesus's mother, the disciple John, and the three others who were there with them. It must have been so painful for Mary. It's awful to have a child of yours die at any age, but to have an adult son brutalized, tortured, and hung on a cross doesn't bear thinking about. And I'm sure as she was watching there at the foot of the cross, she must have thought back over their past life together. Maybe she remembered the day the angel had come from God and told her about the birth of her son and who he would be. Maybe she remembered the trip to Bethlehem for the census and his birth in that stable. I'm sure she would have thought again about how she and Joseph took him to the temple to present him, and what she had been told that day by Simeon, who had said a sword would pass through her own heart. I don't suppose anybody really understood what Simeon was saying. But now, watching Jesus being crucified, Mary, I'm sure, could feel that sword piercing deeper and deeper. And I suspect she would have also remembered the very difficult and challenging times as well, such as when Herod had tried to have Jesus killed. It was the time when he had all male children, 2 years old and under, put to death because he didn't want the King of the Jews to appear. And of course, Mary, Joseph and Jesus had to escape to Egypt. And I'm sure she thought about those days. I'm sure she thought about the time when he preached his first sermon and the neighbours tried to push him off a cliff, or when the Jewish leaders had tried to have him killed. Bad times, but nothing like this. Watching him die upon a cross, his side pierced with a sword, and I'm sure she felt her heart being pierced with the sword that Simeon had spoken about once again. I'm sure as a mother, as she stood there, she remembered how she'd kissed his sweet brow as a little child, held those little hands as he was learning to walk, the same hands that were now nailed to a cross. I'm sure she would think back of the time she had cradled him gently in her arms, and now she sees him suffering on a garbage dump outside the city walls of Jerusalem. But here's the point, Mary was there. Just as we would also, I'm sure, be near to a loved one's deathbed. Because you see, only those that love the one who is in pain have the courage to be there. So on this Mother's Day, Mary shows us why mothers matter so much. And I'm including in that spiritual mothers and mother figures. Because they care, with a care that never ends. Because they nurture their children, those under their care. It's like they're equipping eaglets, baby eagles, to leave the nest. They have understanding for their children. Who knows our needs better than a mother or a spiritual mother or a mother figure? They have a love that is unconditional. They encourage. And there is something indefinable about them. You know, soldiers dying in battle so often cry out at the end for their mothers. And this is why, because mothers are so special, why it's good to have the chance to honour mums and spiritual mums and mother figures again today. So that leads to the second thing I want us to think about, how we value mothers. Let's think about Jesus for a moment and try to put ourselves in his shoes. Jesus said to Mary, "Here, woman, behold your son." Now, you have to understand that Jewish men of that day normally wore 5 pieces of clothing. There would have been a headpiece that went around their head, some type of turban or headdress. They would have had sandals on their feet. They would have had, thirdly, an outer robe which hung loosely to the body and went right down to their ankles. There would have been a girdle, a kind of a sash or a belt that went around that outer garment. And the fifth and final piece they would have worn was an undergarment. Mary, according to Jewish tradition, would almost certainly have lovingly made that undergarment for Jesus. She would have done so as he became a man and made his way in the world. And there from the cross, I suspect Jesus looks and sees that garment lying on the ground as the soldiers cast lots for that and the other items of his clothing. And as he sees it, it symbolises how much his mother loves him. And then his gaze moves to his mother, and he is filled with love and compassion for her. And then he shows us how to love and honour our mothers and our mother figures and our spiritual mothers. Remember, Jesus has been betrayed, arrested, abandoned, falsely tried, tortured, and then executed in the most horrendous way. And yet, despite the gravity of his circumstances, he still thinks of his mother, loves her, cares for her, provides for her, and yes, honours her. Jesus said to John, "Behold your mother." And we know that John cared for Mary from that day on, just as if she was his own mother. Mary was almost certainly a widow at this point of her life, and also an older woman. And though she had other sons, Jesus chose John to provide care for Mary after his death. Why? Because Jesus's brothers did not become believers until after the resurrection. Furthermore, Jesus's brothers were not present at his crucifixion. So Jesus was doing the very best he could for his mother, for Mary. He was entrusting her to John, who was both a believer and who was there. Jesus wanted to care for his mother, and he asks one of his closest friends to take on that responsibility. And of course, John happily obliged. Mary was most likely there with John all the way through, one of the women in the upper room who was present when the church was established in Jerusalem. She probably continued to stay with John in Jerusalem until after her death. Remember, it's only later in John's life that his writings and church history reveal that John finally left Jerusalem and ministered in other areas. Jesus provides this care through John, who takes on the responsibility magnificently. Jesus thinks of his mother, loves his mother, cares for his mother, provides for his mother, honours his mother. And it's a wonderful example to us on Mother's Day. Let us follow his example where mothers are concerned, not just today, but every day. And John, the disciple and the close friend of Jesus, thinks of Mary, loves Mary, cares for Mary, provides for Mary, honours Mary. Let's follow his example where spiritual mothers and mother figures are concerned, not just today, but every day. Because Mary's example shows us why they're worth it, not just today, but every day. Let's pray together on this Mothering Sunday. Gracious God, on this special day, we thank you for mothers, our own mothers and mothers everywhere. We thank you for those who have been such wonderful spiritual mothers, such wonderfully encouraging mother figures. We thank you for all they do, or all they once did, all they give or once gave, all they mean and will always mean. Grant to all entrusted, Father, all those entrusted with the responsibility of motherhood, grant them your wisdom, your guidance, your support. And we thank you that you love us as a mother loves her child, passionately, fiercely, devotedly, wholeheartedly, and that like a mother you watch over us every moment of every day, seeking our welfare, concerned about our progress, equipping us for the journey of life. You are always there when we need you, ready to comfort, encourage and reassure, slow to punish and swift to bless. Gracious God, we call you our Father, but equally you are our Mother. Help us to learn what that means and to rejoice in that truth. And Father, we do ask that you would be particularly close today, all those who have a very, very poor relationship with their mothers. We ask that you would be close today on this sad day for all those where their mothers have died. And Father, we also ask you to be particularly close to mothers who have lost children. We know that this can be a day of mixed emotions, and we ask that you comfort those who find this challenging and sad. But we also ask that you would bless those who rejoice today on Mother's Day. Lord, hear our prayer. We ask it in the name of Christ our Saviour. Amen. Father, as we go, help us to honour and bless mothers and spiritual mothers and mother figures, and help us to bless our families, our church family, and indeed all those who are with us in our human family. Help us to bless them this day and every day. Amen. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us. Have a wonderful day. Have a great week. Continue to stay safe, and God bless you.